गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम टीचर सालुंके टीबी फ्रॉम श्री शिवाजी विद्या मंदिर एंड जूनियर कॉलेज औंध पुणे। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू इन दिस सेशन ऑफ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी स्टडीड सम ऑफ द पैराग्राफ्स फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 18 एंड 19। वी सॉ दैट व्हेन टेंजिंग एंड हिलरी अराइव्ड इन काठमांडू, so there was a sort of controversy between them, but after a little bit discussion, after a talk over it, so everything was clear. Then in the office of Prime Minister of Nepal the pact was made by both of them, Tenzing and Hillary. In the pact we saw the statements made by both the mountaineers, Tenzing and Hillary. We also read the statements made by both the mountaineers and how did they sign the statements. Then when Tenzing and Hillary reached the top of the mountain, so how did Tenzing place his offering to the God? How did he express his thanks, his gratitude to the God? Then we also saw that he made a silent prayer to the God, and he had also carried a few things with him like candy, biscuits and the blue pencil which was given by his youngest daughter Nima. And how did Tenzing put that blue pencil given by his youngest daughter Nima, and how did Hillary, his friend, respond with a big smile when Tenzing put that blue pencil on the summit? Afterwards we also saw that Tenzing got out 4 flags of Great Britain, United Nations, Nepal and India, and he placed all the flags on the string. Its one end was tied to the ice axe. So this is what we studied in the previous session. Today in this session we are going to study the last part of this lesson, on to the summit. We reach the top. So let us begin with the few paragraphs from the lesson on to the summit. We reach the top. So let us look at page number 19. I hope you must be having textbook with you. So students, you look at page number 19 carefully. I read the paragraphs. Students, let us look at the first paragraph on page number 19. I read the paragraph. I was very thirsty. I took out a water tumbler for a drink, but found the water in the metal container had frozen, so I couldn't quench my thirst. I ate some biscuits and offered some to Hillary. So as soon as Tenzing and Hillary reached to the top, get to the top of the mountain, he was extremely thirsty. He needed some kind of water to drink, but as the water was in the metal container and due to the low temperature, the water turned into ice, and therefore when Tenzing wanted to drink water from that tumbler, so the water had frozen due to low temperature, and therefore he could not quench. He could not quench his thirst because he was thirsty, and the water turned into ice due to low temperature. So finally, he ate some biscuits, and he also offered some biscuits to his friend Hillary. Let us move to the next paragraph. I was wearing a red scarf which my great friend Lambert, leader of 1952 Swiss expedition, had given me last year. It was just a year ago, on May 28th, when we were standing at 28,215 feet, that he gave me scar. So in this paragraph, Tenzing describes the red scarf which was given by his friend, whose name is Lambert. So if you look at this paragraph carefully, you will notice that, you will notice the year 1952. In the previous session, when we were reading the statement made by Hillary, so the date was June 22nd, 1953. So students, exactly 1 year ago, 1 year before, Tenzing participated in the Swiss expedition when the Lambert was with him. So when they were with, when they were together in the Swiss expedition in 1952, exactly 1 year ago of this expedition. So at that time, Lambert had given the red scarf to the Tenzing. And in this expedition, Tenzing had this red scarf with him. So what does Tenzing say about the red scarf? I was wearing a red scarf with which my great friend Lambert, leader of the 1952 Swiss expedition. So Lambert was the leader of that particular expedition, which was which they actually participated in 1952. And at that time, Lambert had given that red scarf to the Tenzing. It was just a year ago on May 28th when we were standing at 28,215 feet that he gave me the scarf. So in this way, this red scarf given by Lambert reminded him his great friend Lambert. So that red scarf made Tenzing feel the sense of presence of his great friend Lambert. So this is the significance of the red scarf in this paragraph. Let us move to the next paragraph. I wore it all the way up the mountain from Darjeeling. So the Tenzing wore this red scarf given by Lambert when he started his journey in this expedition from the Darjeeling. As I stood at the top, I remembered him and felt that he was with me. See, the significance of the red scarf. As soon as Tenzing reached the summit of the mountain, the top of the mountain, that red scarf reminded him the presence of his great friend Lambert, with whom he was in the Swiss expedition in 1952. I felt absolutely fit at the summit. So Tenzing describes the fact when he reached the top of the mountain. So he says he was absolutely fit. There was no problem with him when he arrived on the top of the mountain. My mind was absolutely clear. So everything was clear to Tenzing. There was no confusion as far as this expedition, as far as his arrival on the top of the mountain is concerned. I didn't feel tired, I felt exhilarated. See, the success he has achieved, being successful, he forgot each and every worry, burden and tiredness. On the contrary, being successful in this expedition, Tenzing felt exhilarated. Exhilarated means happy. He was happy. In the previous session also, we saw that when they arrived on the top of the mountain, they were overjoyed. It was very clear sensation. So Tenzing could feel this achievement, this success clearly. There was no doubt, confusion in the mind of Tenzing as well as Hilary. Below, all the hills and mountains looked like gods and goddesses to me. The plains below looked like so many broken pieces of the map. So when Tenzing along with Hilary was on the top of the mountain, and when they looked below, so what did they see? All the lands looked like broken pieces, and the land also, the mountains looked like the gods and goddesses. Two or three people could stand there on the roof of the world if you cut ice. So in this next paragraph, Tenzing has given the vivid description, the detailed depiction, description of the top or the summit of the mountain. If we see this paragraph, each and every detail about the summit or the top of the mountain is given in this paragraph. Two or three people could stand there on the roof of the world if you cut ice. So on the top of the mountain, if you cut the ice which is there, so two or three people can stand there comfortably, with comfort, there is no problem. 20 or 30 feet below the top, there was enough flat square for two people to sleep. From the summit, from the top, below 20 or 30 feet, so there is enough space where two persons can sleep. You could pitch one tent there. You can place one tent, small tent, exactly below 20 or 30 feet below the top or the summit of the mountain. The summit is flat on one side and steep on the other. So Tenzing describes both the sides of the summit. On the one side, the summit is flat, and on the other side, there is a steep. Steep means slope. There is snow on the northern side, rocks on the south and east, and snowy rock on the west. See, on the northern side, there was snow. On the south and east side, there were rocks, range of rocks, and snowy rock on the west. And in the west direction, there used to be snowy rocks on the west. We stayed on the top a little more than 15 minutes. We were lucky that there was no gale, or it would have swept us off. My next thought was how to get down safely. So, after spending more than 15 minutes on the summit, on the top of the mountain, Tenzing thought that they were fortunate, they were lucky that there was no strong wind. Let us look at the word gale. Gale means strong wind. If there would have been gale, it could have been very problematic, it could have been very dangerous for Tenzing and Hilary. And therefore, Tenzing felt himself very lucky person due to the absence of gale on the summit, on the top. Otherwise, the gale would have swept both the mountaineers. My next thought was how to get down safely. After spending more than 15 minutes on the summit, the next thought that comes in the mind of the Tenzing, how to get down safely. Let us turn the page. On the descent from the summit, I was walking behind Hillary. I was following him and holding the rope tightly, and my determination was to make sure he descended safely. I must say, the climb down was more difficult and dangerous than the climb up. If you slipped down, you would go into Kangshun Glacier and there would be no trace left of you. So, in this paragraph, Tenzin describes their journey from summit to the down. On the descent from the summit, descent means a way down. So now they are in position to return down. So when they were descending, they were getting down. So Tenzing was behind the Hillary. Hillary was at the lean position. Tenzing was following Hillary. So in that situation, Tenzing says he was holding the rope tightly, and his determination, his thought was to make sure he descended safely. Means Hillary descended safely, because Hillary was at the leading position and Tenzing was following him. I must say that climb down was more difficult and dangerous than the climb up. So here Tenzing is comparing climbing up and climbing down. So according to Tenzing, climbing down is more dangerous and difficult than climbing up. If you slipped down, and the reason is that once you slip down, you would go into Kangshun Glacier. Glacier means the place between two ice sheet. Once you fall there, once you go between the two sheets, ice sheets, so it is very highly impossible for that person to come out of the glacier. And there would be no trace left of you. So it's very dangerous for the mountaineers. They should take the care in that situation. Let us move to the next paragraph. More caution needed. Of course, it took less time climbing down, but needed more hushyar caution. Tenzing says the time which requires for climbing down is less than the time which we need to climb off the mountain. But while climbing down, we have to be hushyar. We have to be very cautious. When I reached Camp 9, my first thought was, thank God we have been spared an accident. And if up to now there have been no accident, I hope there will be none in future. So once again, Tenzing expresses his gratitude to the God. Once again, Tenzing is thankful to God, because as a mountaineer, when he started his mountaineering, there had not been any accident with him, and he also expects that in future also there should not be any accident. I had always prayed to God and he had saved me. So whenever Tenzing started expedition, so he praised God, and according to Tenzing, God saves him. At Camp 9, Hillary and I were in no mood for any talking. So when they returned to Camp 9, see in the first paragraph, in the beginning of the lesson, we had seen that they started their journey from Camp 9 on Friday morning. So they returned to the same Camp 9, but they were no in mood to talk with each other. We just attended to our own things. We stayed there about half an hour. So at Camp 9, they were just focusing on other things, and they stayed at Camp 9 not more than half hour. We boiled some snow to make lemon water and drank it. So in the previous paragraph, we saw that they had metal tumbler, but as the water turned into ice, they could not drink water. So at Camp 9, they boiled some snow and drank some lemon water. When we left, we took only our sleeping bags and left everything else behind in the tent. From Camp 9 to Camp 8, when we spent the night, was an easier job. So they spent night in between Camp 9 and 8. So it was very easy job for them. Just above Camp 8, where the other school see us, I raised my arm with my thumb up. So there were some people at Camp 8, they could see both the mountaineers, successful mountaineers. So at that time, Tenzing raised his thumb up as a sign of success, achievement to the people who were at Camp 8. I raised my arm with my thumb up, noise at WG. Louis saw us and their faces flushed with joy. So Noyce and Louis, when they saw Tenzing and Hillary, both the successful mountaineers, they felt very happy. They also were overjoyed. They also enjoyed this great achievement, success Hillary and Tenzing had got in this expedition. In this way, I was able to tell them of our success. As we got nearer to Camp 8, Lowe came to meet us and came up about 300 feet with tea and coffee. See, when both the mountaineers came nearer to Camp 8, Lowe came with tea and coffee. 300 feet up. So in this way, Louis also felt very happy, and therefore he brought tea and coffee for these successful mountaineers, Tenzing and Hillary. Let us have a look at the last paragraph at page number 20. Another 50 feet down, we met Noyce, who brought us more tea. This tea smelled kerosene. When Tenzing and Hillary came down 50 feet, so Noyce also brought tea which smelled kerosene. Apparently it had been made in a hurry, and somehow some kerosene got into the welcome cup. Perhaps Noyce might have made that tea in a hurry, and therefore some kerosene got into the tea. But I thought, since the gentleman had taken so much trouble to bring it, I was going to enjoy it whatever the smell. See, so Noyce took efforts to make this tea and come to These both the mountaineers. So Tenzing forgot the smell of kerosene. So for Tenzing, taste was not important. The feelings, the way noise brought the tea, that was very significant, that was very important for Tenzing. So this is how we discussed all the paragraphs from the last part of the lesson on to the summit. We reach the top. So how did the story flow from paragraph to paragraph, from the beginning to the end? We discussed the beginning of the expedition. How did Tenzing and Hilary face challenges, some problems, difficulties, obstacles during the expedition? And finally, how did they get the success? And how the people welcomed these successful mountaineers in the last part of the lesson. So students, I hope you must have understood the whole lesson. So you go through the lesson from the beginning, the first paragraph to the last paragraph. Try to understand each and every sentence, words, and also see the activities given in the brainstorming section. So I conclude my lecture here. I stop here. Thank you.